Lord, we ask that as your word comes as the bread of life, that our ears will be willing to hear what you have to say to us. And Father, let our spirits be willing to do what the word will ask us to do. And Father, as your word penetrates our heart, may we be changed, Father God, for the upbuilding of your kingdom. And that salvation and the death of Jesus Christ and the resurrection shall be glorified through our bodies. In the mighty and precious name of Jesus, we do pray. Amen. 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 If you will turn with me to John, that's the gospel according to St. John, the 10th chapter. We're going to look at verses 7 through 10. It is John, the 10th chapter, verses 7 through 13. When you find it, please say, amen. Amen. In John, the 10th chapter, verses 7 through 10. You all amen with me, and I'll be out your way in 10 minutes. Amen. It says, then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. The thief cometh not, but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy. I have come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Amen. I want to talk a little bit about how to spot the devil in church. Amen. How to spot the devil in church. I know what our problem really is when we start dealing, mothers, with the devil is that we have been taught, amen, to look at the devil as this little red man with horns and a pointed tail and a pitchfork. Amen. Amen. TV has got our minds, amen, hypnotized to look at the devil as if we can really see him as this little old funny looking man. Can I get some witnesses in here? I believe if we understood how we could depict when the devil is knocking at our door, I believe in my heart it would allow us to use God more often instead of letting the devil get the victory in our life. Can I get some witnesses in here? I think the problem is that we don't discuss enough the things that the devil can and will do to us. Some people may take and fool you by saying the devil cannot do anything to you, but if you go back and look at Job, God gave the devil permission to do stuff to Job. Can I get some witnesses in here? He didn't just do something by patting him on the back, but God took and allowed Satan to take his family away, mess his house up, take every piece of dime that he could have made off of the cattle, and then afflicted him from his head to toe with sores all over his body. The devil can do something.
Yes, sir.
Something to you. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor,
yeah,
you need to wake up because the devil is knocking at your door. If you don't believe me, the Bible says, well, that's good, evil is always. Always present. The devil is always around looking to see who he can devour. If we go back to Job, the third chapter, the first verse says that when the sons of God went up to acquire of God, it said that Satan was in the midst of the crowd to acquire God too. Oh, y'all better help me in here. And so God asked Satan the question. He said, what are you doing here? Satan being as bold and nasty as he is, he said, I'm here going to and fro looking what I can get into. Can I get some witnesses in here? Oh, I just said something in the text there of Job, the third chapter, because you must realize just because you in church lifting up the name of the Lord, don't get it twisted, baby. The devil might be sitting right next to you. A lot of times we feel like because we're on holy ground that the devil can't go in God's house. But sometimes the devil can get on the inside of you. You bring it in here and he'll use you to cause some hell.
Yes,
turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, I hope you ain't the devil. We get all mixed up because we don't understand. We don't understand, mothers, how he working out. And a lot of times we be looking for one thing when we should be looking for another. Can I get some witnesses in here? We get to tripping off the folk because we feel like, well, she didn't speak to me this Sunday and we got a problem with her, but you don't know what's going on in her life, so the devil is causing hell to rise up in you and say, she ain't gonna speak to me, I ain't gonna speak to her. I gotta help me up in here. And I know some of y'all say speaking is just a habit, but anytime you got God in your heart, you ought to be common, have common sense enough to say, I'm gonna be nice enough to say hello.
Yeah.
I hope everybody and mama taught them better to say hello, good morning, how you doing? Can I get some witnesses in here? Raised a little different, but my grandmama told me, always say hi to somebody.
Yes, sir.
Always be good to a stranger. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, you need to open that mouth and say good morning sometime. Amen. And here we are all mixed up because we don't know how Satan works. We don't know what form he comes in, so we allow him to disrupt the order of the church. And I'm not just talking about the building that we call the church, but I'm talking about every born-again, baptized believer in Jesus Christ. He tears everything up when it comes to us. You see, bald-head preacher, what you talking about?
Yeah,
talking about. When I look at it, it's
a shame that Presbyterians, amen, Episcopalians, amen, the Orthodox Church, Church of God in Christ, Church of Christ, Jehovah's Witnesses,
yes, sir,
Missionary Baptists, Baptists, Primitive Baptists, Free Will Baptists, and whoever else I left out, it's a shame that we can't all come together because we serve the same God.
Amen.
Are y'all gonna help me?
Amen.
And if that ain't the work of the devil, I don't know what it is, because if we all believe in the same God that raised Jesus from the dead, why is there a problem for us to get together in the name of God? Oh yeah. It's a shame because we're gonna pick and choose who we want to be around and fellowship with, but you can't pick and choose God people when all of us are children. So now we sit here with a problem with the church. Folks say, man, we got churches all over the United States. Why are there so many problems? It's because the church has been divided by Satan, and you don't even know you've been divided. Can I get some witnesses in here? Anytime you allow Satan to come in and disrupt, he will do exactly what he's been called to do. So now we sit here with a dilemma and a problem. The church has no power at the time, and everybody needs the church. And I know we can say they need Christ, but see, Christ is in us, and so he told us to be light, amen. And if we got him in us, he wants us to go and share him with other folks, but we can't share him when we got too much hell in us to go out and share Christ with somebody else. It's a shame that folks on the outside can't come in here and feel comfortable, amen, for getting what they need to get from God, because there's too much confusion going on inside the house of prayer. Can I get some witnesses in here? So now we run into a problem where it is trickling down from the church all across the land, that we got a lot of chaos and calamity going on. I understand that the Bible tells us that these days that we live in, they will come, but the church has a responsibility, and a lot of folks will be in a better place if we could get ourselves in line with God's word. It's a shame we can't go out and witness to nobody about anything because we're too busy in here trying to get it right ourselves. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, that boy tell the truth. Turn to the other neighbor and say, neighbor, he said he had 10 minutes. He got 5 left.
Take your time, pal.
Now, as we walk ourselves over to the gospel according to St. John, we look at John today, and John sits here with only the ability that God had blessed it with. But John uses his ability to try and help us see what Jesus is saying in this parable. Can I get some witnesses in here? John, he took time out to write down the necessary words of Christ in order for us to be blessed, that we can see how Satan is gonna come at us. The Bible tells us that Jesus says that I am the door for the sheep. I believe some of us don't realize who we are. So we can't spot the devil because we don't know who we are. I say, can I get some witnesses in here? Some of us want to be sheep, but all of us still acting like goats. Oh, y'all better help me up in here. Because either you're a sheep or you're a goat. And a goat will eat up everything that he can and tear up your house. Y'all better help me in here. A goat is hard-headed. A goat is stubborn. A goat, you can't get along with old Benny Goat.
Come on, man.
But a sheep, Lord have mercy, sheep is so mild, so peaceful, so loving, so trusting. And a lot of us are not anything that I just said.
Yes, sir.
Can I get some witnesses in here? So first we got to identify ourselves. as sheep and act accordingly, then Jesus said that I am the door for the sheep. And what the Lord is saying here is that the only way that you can be saved is that you got to come through me. Confess with your mouth. Hello, somebody. That Jesus Christ died and that he was raised from the grave. Now you will be saved.
Yes, sir.
A lot of us feel like, because I got up there, I thought it was cute because I sat down and I told everybody this and told everybody that. But you just telling us something. But do you believe on the inside of your heart that you got a problem and you need some help?
Yeah.
I believe we got a pew full of people that ain't even saved. Y'all can argue with me if you want to. I can go through the motions like I'm a fireman, but it don't make me a fireman. The only way you can tell that I'm a real fireman is that I've been through basic training that firemen go through and that I've been certified to fight fires.
Oh, yeah.
Better help me here. I can put on a policeman's outfit, hello somebody, but that does not make me a real policeman. I got to go through basic training and be certified as a police officer.
Take your time.
Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, let me see your identification. See, when the police pull you over, first thing they ask for, Derek, is your license and registration. So they got to know something about who you are and what's going on with the car that you're driving. I believe every now and then God needs to pull us over and say, let me see your license and your registration. Some of us have made up some fake IDs and we're not who we say we are. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, So now John sits here, and I'm just about done now.
Take your time.
It allows us to see that the only way we can be changed in our lives is that we got to come to Jesus and be saved by the blood of Christ. Then he says, there are some that's going to be in the midst of the church. And I'm just paraphrasing what the scripture is really saying here. That they come as thieves. See, what you got to realize is that whenever something is going good in your life, that's when the devil want to try to make you start cursing God instead of blessing God for what you do now. Now, better help me in here. I can't stand it when everything's not going right in my life, and next thing I know, I got somebody, I always got something negative to say about what's going on. But you don't know where I've been and what I'm going through, but I know God is working in my life. If you don't like it, then get away from me. You don't understand my relationship with the Lord. So while you keep yapping in my ear, I can't hear you no more. Because my eyes is on God. Brother Christine, I found it is hard for us to stay focused because we're too worried about what other folks got to think about us when we should be more worried about what God thinks about us, since we have told God that we're going to change our lives and we've given him our life and that we're going to give him glory. Oh, somebody help me in here. You know how we get up in church and we start lying to one another saying, the Lord heard my cry, pity my heavy groan. Well, if he really done that, what are you doing for God? But there's some folks in the midst of us gonna shout just like you. Some of them gonna know the Bible just as good as you do. Can I get some witnesses in here? Some of them might even give better money than some of us give. But that don't make them a child of God. Some folks that come in here, when you see them cry, when they come up and take the seat and say that they either want to come by loud Christian experience or by way of baptism, you must understand that they got an agenda that's set by Satan to come in here and start some stuff. Can I get some witnesses in here? Everybody don't have the same mind frame. Some women come to church just looking for a man. Some men come Now you get mad at me for telling the truth. It happens. I know about it. We done had some folks come through here like that. Getting hit by first after Sunday, by Tuesday, here they go. My life be a $700-something, I would say. No. Baby, we don't do it like that. We see what we can do, but we're not going to do it like that. Ain't that I'm trying to be nasty, but the Bible says, be wise as a serpent, but humble as a dove. So the Lord is saying, you got to have some sense to know that the devil is going to be in the midst of you. Yeah! Things are good around here. It's going good. But understand that the devil is just waiting to figure out what he's going to do next. I started looking at my health getting better there, and I started saying, man, now I feel like doing more as the pastor. Now I done come to being able to go visit the sick at the hospital. That's why I went to see Deacon Smith, and I told him, I said, Deacon, don't think I don't want to see y'all in the hospital, but sometimes I can go and I can't go because it plays tricks with my mind, and if I go see you in the hospital, then that means my heart going to stop working, and I'm going to wind up dying while I'm at the hospital seeing you. But I said, I'm going to go see my deacon. I don't give a care about what the devil trying to make me think. I'm going to bless the deacon today. Got in there and felt good. Felt good all day yesterday. I'm working on my fight. Because I know what God has for me to do here, and now I realize, hello somebody, that as we start going higher in God, the devil is going to raise some even higher hell here. Don't start saying, man, I don't know why folks are starting to leave. They ain't leaving because something is wrong here. They leaving because the devil can't be welcome in a place of praise. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, devil ain't welcome in a place of praise. Now you know why he ain't welcome in a place of praise? Now listen to this. We know that he can come to church with us and sit right in here. But once the church get together and give a heartfelt praise to God, guess what's going to happen? He's going to get upset because he don't want us to praise God, but he wants us to praise him. Y'all better hear me now. If you don't read your Bible in the beginning, Satan wanted all the praise and the glory for himself. That's why God kicked him out of the choir and sent him down here on earth. And here he is looking real nasty and ugly because he don't have what he could have.
Yes, sir. Take on that.
So now we sit here. I got to get out of here, man.
Get out, Doc.
Sit here, and Jesus says, he says, the thief caught not, but to steal. We must realize that the way you can spot the devil in the church is you watch the thieves that come in here. Can I get some witnesses in here? Malachi lets us know, shall a man rob God of his tithes and offering? I'm going to go there first. So when we get that out the way, I can show you something else. How can you love the Lord but steal from him of your tithes and offerings? And you know, sometimes Helen has to talk to me. But she said, well, Marcus, you know people have a hard time. I say, Helen, let me tell you something, baby. I said, hard times is when you can't hardly do nothing for yourself. But if I'm getting my hair done, my nails done, I'm wearing something new every Sunday, I might as well stop lying that I can't put no more than $10 in church because you got a lot of money going into your house. Well, now, God is a church house man. So if he can't tell me how to spend my money, I'm just saying that if you put your priorities together, that little hat that you got done, you can get some better hat if you bless the Lord.
Yes, sir.
I can't do a car. Well, why didn't got so much on me? Then we go on out and we're taking cruises and everything else. Hello, somebody. We come in here and put $5 in the plate. The Lord bless you to come up with the money to take a cruise. Why don't you come back with joy in your heart saying, Lord, thank you for letting me go see San Juan, because I wouldn't have never been able to see San Juan if it wasn't for you. So I want to give the church $100.
Amen.
Boy, it's so quiet. I like it like that. Dear, don't even play that for a while. I love it when it's quiet. Folks come to steal. They come to steal your joy in service. you've been in here and you had nothing but joy in your heart. Because when you got here, God was blessing you and the service was going great, and that one person come and steal your joy.
Yes, sir.
Y'all better help me up here. Yeah. Sometimes they ain't got to do nothing but just look at you crazy and they'll steal your joy. Because you're trying to figure out what's going on instead of keeping your eye on your praise. Can I get some witnesses in here? So we got to beware that there are folks that come in here and steal. Not only does the members steal, there's preachers that will take every dime that you got. Every time you look around, the preacher needs something. Amen. I know preachers, they got to have their clothes washed and cars washed and everything else. I know it's going to be on TV, but I'm going to let you know. I'm not real skinny. The church been taking care of me, and I ain't got to beg nobody for nothing anyway, because God will supply all my needs according to me. You for something. I'm begging for it. God told me, don't be the beggar.
Yes, sir.
Oh, somebody better help me in here. Beg nobody for nothing. God take care of you. Now, another way to spot the devil is find the killer of the church.
Come on, man.
I've noticed my 6 years of pastor, Sister Gordon, that the folks come in here and say, Pastor, I love you. I love every member of the church. We having such a good time. Ooh, Lord Jesus. But soon as we don't do what they want us to do, they'll start talking about this church, and they start talking about the preacher. Now, I thought you said you loved us and you loved the church. Love me, but now, since you didn't get what you wanted your way, now the church is all messed up.
Yes, sir.
Try to kill what's going on in the church. Not only do they that, but they trying to kill your spirit that you don't come, keep coming here no more. Because see, I don't know if y'all realize it or not. You're here because God put you here. It ain't because I'm the greatest preacher in Nashville, Tennessee. It's because God brought you here and you got what you need right here for right now. Can I get some witnesses in here? I'm T.D. Jakes or somebody. I know I don't have that, but God gave Marcus what I need. Because I see him working through me. He's blessing other folk because I'm with it. So now they're trying to kill your destination that God has for you. And that's dangerous. Because I don't know about you, devil, but when I Deacon Ball, I know you travel in a truck. But when I was going in my truck and the directions weren't right, I'm not from New York, but that's the worst feeling is when